Hello everyone, welcome to Real Academy. Myself Vinit Mohite, the faculty for biology, and today we'll be learning about one topic here, which is regarding your eyes from the standard 10th ICSE. And the topic's name, or is the chapter's name, is sense organs. We all know that within this chapter we have been learning with two organs here, that is eyes as well as your ears. Firstly, we'll be looking at this structure, or is this organ, how this organ works as a sense organ within the human body. We all know we have a pair of it, as well as it's important for a sense called as vision. We all know that. Now, vision, basically how it started or how it basically developed, first we'll be looking at that, and then we'll be starting with the human eyes. So first organism jiske paas eyes the, we don't know exactly about that, but we do know that there was something called as hydra, or else coelenterates, the animals which we learned in 9th standard ICSE. Coelenterates, or hydra, the coelenterata, the organism which has a cylindrical body, that organism basically had the first eyes. But those eyes were not exactly like us. Those were just sensory eyes, which means what? Whenever hydra used to get light, hydra used to move away, or else hydra used to show motion whenever there was light around him. So that's why hydra had something regardless, I mean something close to the eyes. Later on, what we got was actually the pit eyes, which we'll be looking forward. And after that, we have got something else called as lenses. Wo sab aapke paas dheere dheere aaye the. And why those eyes are important in your body? Eyes are basically important for something that is regulating this levels of a hormone called as melatonin. Now, this is the hormone which is produced by your brain. Aapka brain ye hormone banata hai. And once this hormone is made, what is happening is this hormone gives you sleep. But how you will get sleep? Only when you close your eyes. When you close your eyes, there's a structure inside our brain called as suprachiasmatic nucleus, SCN, jo structure ye hormone banane wala hai, called as melatonin. Once the melatonin is made, your body will be going under sleep. So your eyes are actually important for regulating melatonin, or else for regulating this called as circadian rhythm. Circadian rhythm, as we already know, कि हमारे पास एक specific time रहता है खाने का, specific time रहता है उठने का, specific time रहता है सोने का. All this, I mean, related to sleep, how it is actually occurring within your body, just because of this organ called as eye. When your eye is closed, suprachiasmatic nucleus inside your brain gets activated and it makes one hormone called as melatonin. Just like we know pituitary gland makes one hormone called as growth hormone, because of which your bones are growing. Similarly, the melatonin hormone, which is made by suprachiasmatic nucleus SCN, which is regulated by the brain, once this hormone is made, it will give you sleep. You all must be knowing why coffee as well as tea doesn't give you sleep, or it's why they keep you awake. Just because coffee and tea, both of them contain one chemical called as caffeine. Caffeine or melatonin, both will compete with each other to sit on the brain. Okay, these hormones basically stick to the brain. So once any hormone is sticking to the brain, for example, if caffeine sticks over the brain, after competing with melatonin, you will be awake. But if caffeine is not there inside your body, this is the hormone basically which will be actually working there. Similarly, eyes, will be talking about them here. We can see the first eye in the world, basically with a Nolitus. Animal's name is Nolitus, while that animal is a mollusk. We must be knowing about phylum Mollusca, soft bodied structures with a shell over them. Example, even snail is an example of this. Even octopus is an example of this particular group of animals, Mollusca. Okay, now this animal had the first eye. You can see the pit eye here. Right, in this eye you can see a middle hole, a black colored hole, right? What we have inside our eye, a black colored hole, but that black colored hole has something beyond it, that is your lens. This organism, they don't have lens. Inke paas lens bilkul nahi rehta. First organism who had basically a complete eye, jis eye ke wajah se he can see the world. Okay, earlier organisms, earlier to them, had an eye which was not used for image formation. Like we talked about hydra. Hydra doesn't use to form image because of it. Hydra ke paas sirf sensory cells the. Platyhelminths, the flatworms, they had the sensory cells. But this worm, not a worm basically, but an animal with a soft body and a shell, I mean mollusca. So this animal basically had a complete eye with its retina behind. We'll be talking about the retina. But over that retina, there was no lens, there's no ciliary muscles, nothing else. This eye, or this organism, was present since 544 million years ago, which means you can say around 54 crore years ago was the time when you actually got one eye like this. And later on it started developing. We can see another developed eye here, which is with mosquito, also with house flies. We can see the eye there. See, it's a compound eye. You can see how many lenses are there. so many lenses, which means if you are standing in front of a mosquito, mosquito will see thousands of you. Okay, मतलब उसके पास हजारों लेंस है, तो हजारों लेंस के वजह से वो आपको हजार इमेजेस बनाने वाला है. एंड ही विल सी दैट देयर इज नॉट जस्ट वन पर्सन स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी, देयर आर मेनी सच पीपल हु आर स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी. दैट्स कॉल्ड अ कंपाउंड आई. बोथ ऑफ दिस आईज आर बेसिकली नॉट प्रेजेंट विद इन ह्यूमंस. ह्यूमंस हैव अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ आई, एंड अबाउट दैट आई विल बी टॉकिंग हियर. फर्स्टली, एज वी ऑलरेडी नो दैट आर आईज हैव समथिंग ओवर देम कॉल्ड एज आईलिड्स. Before talking about eyelids, we also must be knowing about voluntary muscles, the muscles which are controlled by our body. Our eyelids are voluntary muscles, which muscles are basically controlled by your brain, and therefore we can control when to close our eyes, when to not close our eyes. That's called as eyelids. जो आपके आई के ऊपर as well as नीचे भी रहेंगे, has pigments, and therefore those pigments can change in the course of the disease. Your eyes get some color. You must be knowing your eyelids get some color. Okay. Similarly, many organisms have a third eyelid, as you can see here. The third eyelid over this eagle. What does this third eyelid means? This third eyelid is a nictitating membrane present over that eagle. That membrane actually is a transparent membrane which can be flapped over the eye, and therefore that eagle can see something. Plus, that eagle will not get any infection or any dust entering into his eyes just because of that nictitating membrane. We don't have a nictitating membrane. They have that, and therefore it's an advantage with the eagles, as you can see here. This nictitating membrane, whenever there's any danger or any obstacle in front of them, they will close their eyes with the nictitating membrane. We should know nictitating membrane is completely transparent. These are the eyelids, the yellow colored one. Okay, while this is just a nictitating membrane, we had nictitating membrane for our eyes protection too, but we lost that in the course of evolution. We can see this pink colored muscle here, which is actually the nictitating membrane of humans, but that was actually got away, and we didn't have those nictitating membranes today. It's a vestigial organ, it's not working today. But within some animals like this, even crocodiles, they have this nictitating membrane. We must be knowing about even one cobra called as spitting cobra, which spits venom. So that spitting cobra, if it spits venom, and if that venom goes into the eyes, eagle has that advantage of covering its eyes, and therefore nothing will go inside, and therefore his eyes will be completely protected. If I am standing in front of the spitting cobra, I will be completely blind because I don't have something like this nictitating membrane. That's an extra protection, which we can even call it as the third eyelid. Next one, as you can see the disease there. Okay, that disease is called as nocturnal lagophthalmos. Let us just write it first. The disease is called as nocturnal lagophthalmos. Nocturnal means at night. Lagophthalmos, your eye is not completely closed there. Aapka eye completely band nahi hota wahan pe. Aisa kyun hota hai? It's a disease there. Because ye jo eyelids ke muscles hai, hum log ne already bola ki ye muscles voluntary hai, right? Our muscles are voluntary, and those muscles will be controlled with the brain. Brain agar ye muscles ko control kar raha hai, iska matlab brain se neurons in muscles tak aa raha hai, aur jiske wajah se aapka ye muscle controlled hai. Therefore we can close our eyes every time. But here that nerve, that neuron which is actually from the brain to the eye, to the eyelids, that neuron is actually not working properly. इसके पास ब्रेन का कनेक्शन नहीं है, एंड देयरफॉर दोज आईलिड्स कैन नॉट बी क्लोज्ड इवनली. एंड देयरफॉर व्हाट दिस पीपल डू इज व्हेनेवर दे स्लीप, दे हैव सच अ कंडीशन विद देयर आईज. इट्स एन एक्चुअल थिंग, दे डू स्लीप लाइक दिस. द थिंग हियर इज देयर आईलिड्स विल बी इन डेंजर, और देयर आईज विल बी इन डेंजर जस्ट बिकॉज आईज आर ओपन. एनी डस्ट पार्टिकल्स एंड एनीथिंग इन द एयर कैन सेटल ऑन देयर आईज, एंड देयरफॉर दे कैन गेट एन इन्फेक्शन. व्हाट कैन वी डू इन द केस ऑफ नॉक्टर्नल लैगोप्थेल्मोस? इफ द केस गेट्स सीवियर, व्हाट विल डॉक्टर डू इज डॉक्टर विल परफॉर्म अ सर्जरी. He will cut the skin here. The skin will be cut, and inside to that skin there will be added something called as gold particles. Gold will be added inside. That gold will be added inside, your eyelid will be stitched, and once your eyelid is stitched, now your eyes can fall down. Why? Because gold is a metal, as we already know, it has higher gravity, and therefore your eyelids will fall like this once you're sleeping, and therefore you can get a proper sleep. That's the method which is done by the doctors. But why gold should be inserted there? Why gold should be inserted? I would like your answers here in the comment section, why gold will be inserted there. Okay, after that we'll be moving towards the next slide regarding your tear glands. Tear glands are basically the glands present at the upward side of your eye, which are actually making tears. Why do we make tears? We don't know exactly, but we do know that tears have something, a protein that protein actually helps to keep your eyes out of infections, to prevent your eyes from infection. There's one protein which can break the cell membrane, cell walls of bacteria, and therefore bacteria cannot give the infection of your eyes. They do give it, but sometimes the bacteria will be modified there. Okay, those tear glands actually they drain the tears from a duct called as lacrimal duct. आपका जो tear यहाँ से बाहर निकलने वाला है, एक duct से वो सब tube बाहर निकलता है, and that tube will be present here, and from here that all tears will be getting out. Also, this gland is connected to your nose. You'll be looking at the image, how it is connected to your nose. Let us go at that image. We can see here that this is your tear gland, as well as you can see a duct here. And that duct basically runs through your nose. We can see here. And therefore, why you have a running nose whenever you cry? Okay, whenever we cry, जब भी हम लोग रोते हैं, हम लोग के पास running nose क्यों होता है? हम लोग को सर्दी क्यों होती है? Okay, we do every time. We do sniffle so that our mucus goes up. Okay, why do that happen? Just because your tears, which are made in the tear glands, will fall here. They will go out, but even they will be entering into the lacrimal duct. आपका इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं lacrimal duct, or else specifically nasolacrimal duct. Naso means your nose. Lacrimal मतलब वहाँ से tears बाहर निकलते हैं, और वही tears आपके nose से भी बाहर आना start होते हैं, जिसके वजह से आपको सर्दी होती है. So why do you get that particular thing whenever you are crying? Just because आपके जो भी tears है वो आपके नाक से भी निकलने वाले, जिसके वजह से आपको सर्दी जैसा feeling आता है. But once your crying is done, एक बार हमारा रोना खत्म हो गया, वो tears वहाँ से निकल जाते हैं. Tears भी निकलने के बाद आपके nose का भी complete area clean हो जाता है, and now you can take the air inside. But whenever you are crying and if you are taking the air inside, you can feel that you are actually sniffling anything into the nose. Okay, just like हम लोग को जब सर्दी होती है, हम लोग क्या करते हैं? Same way we are doing here. Okay, that's how your nose and your eyes both are connected. Let us move forward towards another part, which is called as conjunctiva, a transparent layer over my eye. एक ट्रांसपेरेंट लेयर रहता है, मोस्टली मेड अप ऑफ लिक्विड, एंड दैट लिक्विड बेसिकली प्रोटेक्ट्स और एल्स डजंट अलाउ एनीथिंग टू एंटर इनसाइड माय आईज. नाउ द एयर अराउंड मी, दैट एयर मे बी कंटेनिंग डस्ट पार्टिकल्स, माइक्रोस्कोपिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स एज वेल एज माइक्रोस्कोपिक डस्ट टू, दैट डस्ट कैन इजीली एंटर माय आई, बट एक्चुअली दे आर नॉट एंटरिंग जस्ट बिकॉज माय आई हियर इट हैज अ ट्रांसपेरेंट लेयर, अ ट्रांसपेरेंट लिक्विड लेयर. जस्ट ट्राई और एल्स डोंट ट्राई दिस, बट जस्ट व्हेनेवर यू हैव योर फिंगर इंसर्टेड हियर इनटू द व्हाइट कलर ऑफ योर eye, what happens is your finger will be moist. Why? Because your finger actually is touching that water, and that water is known as, that layer is known as conjunctiva, जो आपके eyes के सामने रहता है. That conjunctiva is basically producing a jelly-like material, and that jelly-like material basically protects your eyes. Now what happens is, you already always you blink. Okay, we blink many times a day. Why do we blink? Because whenever our eyes are open, this conjunctiva is a jelly-like material. What will happen is, if our eyes are completely open for some time, what will happen due to outer air, it will get dried up. Your conjunctiva will be dried up. अगर conjunctiva dry होगा, then you blink your eyes. क्योंकि आप लोग जब भी blink करते हो आपके आँखों को, तो वो conjunctiva again gets regenerated. Your conjunctiva again becomes moist, not dry, moist, and therefore you can again see something easily. Otherwise, what will happen? You already know your eyes will start burning somewhat. Okay, तो वो आपको feeling आता है वहाँ पे, वो sensation हम लोग को आने वाला है, just because of conjunctiva. Similarly, conjunctiva is a jelly-like material. It must be containing some nutrients, some salts, and therefore it can even lead to an infection, and that infection is called as trachoma. Let us look at that infection here. So that's the actual infection. You can see the infection here. See, this is the actual infection, a bacterial infection of Chlamydia trachomatis. This is the name of the bacteria which gives the infection of your eyelids. Your eyelids, the upward eyelid, if we can open it like this, the upward eyelid is basically making that jelly-like material called as conjunctiva. वो conjunctiva वहाँ पे बनाया जा रहा है, लेकिन वो conjunctiva अगर वहाँ पे jelly-like material है, which means there is food, bacteria, if they get in contact with there, they will lead to trachoma, the infection. Now, if you have trachoma, what happens is, the layer here, this layer dies. If this layer dies, it will not produce the jelly-like material, and therefore your eyes become completely rough, as you can see the color here, white color. Okay, आपके eyes completely rough बन जाते हैं. Now this rough eyelids basically are scratching over your eye. आपके आँखों के ऊपर वो लोग हमेशा बंद हो रहे हैं, ओपन हो रहे हैं, इसका मतलब वो आपके आँखों को स्क्रैच करने वाले, it will be scratching your eyes, and that can lead to something called as blindness. उसके वजह से आपके पास blindness आ सकता है, क्योंकि scratching के वजह से आपका lens खराब हो सकता है, and if your lens goes damaged, you can have blindness. Okay, you can see the conjunctiva here. This is the outer conjunctiva. Okay, और वो conjunctiva basically आपके eyelids के वजह से बन रहा है, ये eyelids के अंदर का layer है. as it is red, which means it contains blood vessels. Blood vessels do contain plasma. Plasma contains 90% water, and that is the water because of which your conjunctiva is made, so that your eyes are kept moist every time. Okay, let us move forward. We can see at this image, you can see a smaller hole here, जो हम लोग ने lacrimal duct बोला था, regarding this section, from where your tears are coming out whenever you cry. So that's the section here. Tears actually come out from this part. This is actually the nictitating membrane, जिसके बारे में हम लोग ने third eyelid बोला था, regarding the eagle image. तो वो आपका nictitating membrane यहाँ पे रहता है, completely vestigial, will not be working it. Okay, similarly we did talk about trachoma, right? Next, let us move towards the next section. Structure of the eyeball. Now we'll be coming towards that eyeball here, which is present inside both the white as well as the black part. Let us move towards it. Eyeball contains basically three layers. First layer is called as sclera. As you can see the sclera here, the white colored layer. Okay, it is called as sclera. Why and what is the importance of sclera? You can see something is attached to the sclera, and that something are called as muscles. They are muscles, and those muscles are also called as extra ocular muscles. Extra means outside the eye, ocular means your eyes, and those muscles, what they are doing is all those muscles from the back, they are connected to the brain. So brain basically moves your eyes to the left, to the right, as well as upwards and downwards. Why your eyes are moving? Just because wo jo muscles hai, wo muscles aapke eyes ko control karte. Those muscles will allow the movement of your eye anywhere. But those muscles are basically attached to the sclera, as we already know. As you age, jaise jaise aapka age badhta hai, वैसे वैसे आपके एनर्जी लेवल्स कम होते जाते हैं. बट स्टिल इफ यू आर ईटिंग समथिंग, आई मीन वी डू ईट एवरी टाइम, बट वेन एवर वी ईट समथिंग, इफ इट्स फैट, तो फैट आपके स्क्लेरा में डिपॉजिट होता है एंड योर स्क्लेरा टर्न्स येलो, ओके, समवॉट येलो. ओके, दैट्स नॉट जॉन्डिस, दैट्स जस्ट एन एक्चुअली डिसीज ड्यू टू एज. इट्स एन एज रिलेटेड डिसीज जहां पे आपके फैट के डिपॉजिट्स आने वाले. जस्ट लाइक यू नो यू हैव फैट डिपॉजिट्स विद इन योर ब्लड वेसल्स टू. इफ यू हैव अ ब्लड वेसल लाइक दिस, you get a fat deposit because of which blockage can occur. Similarly, वही fats आपके इस conjunctiva में भी deposit हो सकते हैं, and because of which conjunctiva can turn yellow in color. Okay, वो आपका actually sclera का part है, जहाँ पे आपके extraocular muscles भी connected रहेंगे. Now we'll be looking at an image of a sclera. You can see the sclera here, but you can see one major difference between this image and this actual image. What has happened here? You can see some red colored linings. What are those linings? So those linings are, those linings are blood vessels. Okay, ये सब के सब blood vessels है. You must have seen whenever you are awake, you don't get such red colored linings. But whenever you sleep and then you get awake at 6 a.m., 7 a.m. or even at 10 a.m. So हम लोग बहुत सारे को आदत रहती है वो. तो हम लोग के पास ऐसे red color के linings आ जाते हैं. What do this red colored lining means? This red colored linings are basically the blood vessels which have been somewhat become bigger in size. Okay, so normally what happens inside your body, inside your sclera, is whenever you are awake, your blood vessels are smaller like this. Okay, thinner. They are basically thinner. Whenever you sleep, you close your eyelid. Once you close your eyelids, those blood vessels become bigger in size like this. Okay, they become bigger in size. Now, why they are becoming bigger in size only when you sleep? The reason behind this is really simple. Whenever your eyes are open, आजू बाजू में air है, air में oxygen है, that oxygen will be entering into this layer and will be giving nutrition, right? Oxygen basically gives the ability for the cells to give, to perform aerobic respiration. But whenever you close your eyes, oxygen will not be entering into this part, right? If oxygen is not entering into this part, यहाँ के जो blood vessels है वो लोग बड़े हो जाते हैं, जैसे आप लोग देख सकते हो red colored blood vessels, वो blood vessels बड़े हो जाएंगे और वो लोग अपना oxygen इसको देंगे. Normally what happens is your body, inside your body, for example, heart, stomach, liver, intestine, everything, all those organs basically are getting oxygen because they have a blood supply. If any organ has blood supply, he will be obviously getting oxygen. Sclera has blood supply, and therefore sclera, because of this blood vessels, can easily get oxygen, right? But this part never has blood vessels. So if this part has blood vessels, what will happen is here there will be a blood supply. Even if you sleep, they are getting the blood. But whenever you sleep, your eyelids are closed. If my eyelid is closed, this part will not get oxygen. If it is not getting oxygen, what will happen is the surrounding blood vessels will become bigger like this, and therefore it will get oxygen. So what happens whenever you are awake in the morning? What happens there? आपके ब्लड वेसल्स बड़े हो जाते हैं। क्यों? क्योंकि आप लोग रात को सोए हो, 8 घंटा आप लोग सोए हो या फिर 9 घंटा या फिर 10 घंटा, एनी टाइम, बट वेन एवर यू आर अस्लीप वॉट हैपन्स देयर इज योर ब्लड वेसल्स और इज दिस पार्ट द बेसिक लेंस इज नॉट गेटिंग ऑक्सीजन। इफ इट इज नॉट गेटिंग ऑक्सीजन कैन इवन डाय, द सेल्स मे डाय, एंड इफ द सेल्स डाय देर कैन बी अ प्रॉब्लम टू योर आईज, यू कैन इवन टर्न ब्लाइंड। सो देयर फोर जस्ट अस टू प्रोवाइड द ऑक्सीजन देयर योर ब्लड वेसल्स ग्रो बिगर इन साइज, एंड वेन एवर यू आर अवेक इन द मॉर्निंग ब्लड वेसल्स कैन बी सीन बिगर, बट एज यू कीप योर आईज ओपन फॉर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम ये ब्लड वेसल्स छोटे होने वाले हैं। क्यों? ऑब्वियस है, इसको अभी हवा से ऑक्सीजन मिल रहा है तो इसके वजह से ब्लड वेसल्स विल गो डाउन। लेट अस सी एट द नेक्स्ट इमेज हियर, यू कैन सी दिस। नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दिस? इट्स कॉल्ड एज ब्लड शॉर्ट आई। व्हाट हैज हैपेंड हियर? योर स्क्लेरा, द ब्लड वेसल्स हैव बीन ब्रोकन डाउन। इट कैन बी ड्यू टू ट्रॉमा, इट कैन बी ड्यू टू एनी इंजरी, और एल्स इट कैन बी ड्यू टू वन डिसीज कॉल्ड एज हाइपरटेंशन। वी ऑल नो हाइपर मीन्स ज्यादा, टेंशन मीन्स प्रेशर ऑन द ब्लड वेसल्स, विच मीन्स दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज हाई ब्लड प्रेशर। Whenever we have a chance or whenever we have that disease of high blood pressure, what happens inside our body is you normally have blood vessels of this range, but the blood vessels gets bigger. Why? Because large amount of blood is flowing at a faster rate. बहुत जोर से वो blood flow हो रहा है, इसके वजह से वो arteries के ऊपर pressure डालते हैं और आपके arteries ऐसे बड़े हो जाते हैं, फिर veins के ऊपर pressure डालते हैं और आपके veins ऐसे बड़े हो जाते हैं। Once they get bigger like this, if they are becoming bigger beyond a level, they will tear off. वो लोग फट जाएंगे। वो लोग फटने के बाद ऐसा एक रेड कलर का स्पॉट आपको आपकी आंखों में दिखता है, विच मीन्स आपकी आंखों में खून बाहर है, कि वो भी आपके आंखों में ही रहेगा, धीरे धीरे इट विल बी टर्निंग ऑफ, बट दैट हाई ब्लड प्रेशर इज अ बेसिक प्रॉब्लम। अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, इंजरी इज अगेन अ प्रॉब्लम विच कैन टीयर दिस ब्लड वेसल्स, एंड देयरफॉर ब्लड विल बी लोकेटेड हियर, ब्लड विल बी स्टक देयर विद इन योर स्क्लेरा। इसके वजह से स्क्लेरा बिकम्स एन इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट एज वेल एज फॉर सप्लाइंग द ऑक्सीजन, इवन इट्स एन इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट एज फार एज द केयर इज कंसर्न, टू टेक द केयर ऑफ योर स्क्लेरा जस्ट टू अवॉइड ऑल दिस प्रॉब्लम विच कैन ऑकर टू योर स्क्लेरा। दिस इज अ नॉर्मल फेनोमिनन, बट दिस कैन ऑकर ड्यू टू एनी इंजरी और एल्स मोस्ट प्रोबेबली ड्यू टू हाइपर टेंशन। ओके, लेट अस मूव टुवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट पार्ट। विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द नेक्स्ट थिंग हियर कॉल्ड एज कोरॉइड लेयर। लेट अस टॉक अबाउट इट। इट हैज अ वैस्कुलर स्ट्रक्चर। विल बी टॉकिंग वेर इज द कोरॉइड लेयर प्रेजेंट। इट इज अ वैस्कुलर स्ट्रक्चर। वैस्कुलर मीन्स वहाँ पे बहुत सारे ब्लड वेसल्स रहने वाले, अपार्ट फ्रॉम विच कोरॉइड इज इन्वॉल्व इन लिमिटिंग रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द आई। विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट वॉट डू वी मीन बाई दिस सेकंड पॉइंट। कोरॉइड अगेन हैज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज मेलानिन। लाइक वी हैव melanin under our skin, because of which our skin turns black in color. Okay, we must be knowing that skin has varied colors. The people who are darker, basically they have a black colored skin. Why? Because they have high amounts of melanin. Someone who are actually not darker but fairer, they will be not having that much amount of melanin. For example, European people, तो उनके अंदर melanin ज़्यादा नहीं रहता उनके skin के अंदर. Okay, so melanin कब बढ़ेगा आपके skin के अंदर? If you are exposed to sunlight. So just as a protective mechanism, your body starts to make a large amount of melanin. It's a protective mechanism. Remember that. If your body is turning black, it's not a disease. It's a protective mechanism done by your body to protect yourself from the diseases which can occur due to UV rays from the sun. Okay, let us move towards it. See, this part is called as choroid. This darker colored part, it has melanin, it will be darker. Similarly, it has large number of blood vessels. Now it performs limiting the reflections. What do we mean by that? If light comes here, okay, and that light will turn here, will reflect anywhere, you know, reflection of light, okay, at an angle, angle of incidence, angle of reflection, we all know about it. So light har jagah pe reflect hona start hoga. वो लाइट ज़्यादा रिफ्लेक्ट नहीं हो सकता क्योंकि आपके पास कोरॉइड का लेयर है। अगर लाइट बहुत ज़्यादा रिफ्लेक्ट होगा, समझो इफ देयर इज वन पर्सन स्टैंडिंग हियर एंड इफ लाइट रिफ्लेक्ट फ्रॉम हिम, सो विच मीन्स लाइट विल फॉल हियर, वन इमेज, इट विल रिफ्लेक्ट हियर, सेकंड इमेज, इट विल रिफ्लेक्ट हियर, थर्ड इमेज, फोर्थ इमेज, फिफ्थ इमेज, ऐसे बहुत सारे इमेज सपोज एक इंसान के दिखेंगे, ऐसा नहीं होता। यू जस्ट सी वन इमेज ऑफ दैट ब्राइटर ऑब्जेक्ट। वाई? बिकॉज वंस लाइट फॉल्स एट अ पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट, दैट लेयर इज डार्कर, इट विल एब्जॉर्ब द लाइट। If it is absorbing the light, that light will not reflect anywhere else. And that's why choroid is important. Choroid is important for limiting the reflections. It will absorb the light. As we all know, it has high amount of melanin. So which means what? It will be absorbing the light. Agar wo light ko absorb karega, to choroid basically aapke paas multiple images form nahi karta. That's about the choroid layer. Similarly, we can see something here. Right? The red colored eyes. Why this red colored eyes occur to you? Just because of this. यू नो ना, वेन एवर वी आर हैविंग अ फोटोशूट और इज फ्लैश लाइट फोटोग्राफी, जब भी आपके पास फ्लैश रहता है तभी आपकी आंखें ऐसी लाल ही दिखती है. व्हाई? बिकॉज लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ लाइट इज एंटरिंग इनसाइड योर आईज. And if that large amount of light enters, it will be brightening the choroid layer. We already know choroid has large number of blood vessels, which means choroid is actually red in color. तो आपको ऐसा red color का choroid आपकी आंखों के अंदर आपको दिख रहा है. कि that's why your eyes turn red, because your choroid actually is red in color. Light बहुत सारा अंदर आएगा और वो light हर जगह पर reflection करेगा, वो बहुत ज़्यादा है. That cannot be actually absorbed by your choroid. Choroid is actually a smaller structure. It will not absorb large amount of light. So once large amount of light enters due to flash photography, What happens? ये टोटल स्ट्रक्चर आपको रेड कलर का दिखेगा क्योंकि अंदर बहुत सारे ब्लड वेसल्स है. ऑब्वियसली आपका ब्लड भी रेड कलर का है. समझो अगर आपका ब्लड ग्रीन कलर का होता अंदर आपको ग्रीन कलर दिखता था. बट यू आर लुकिंग एट अ रेड कलर देयर एंड देयरफॉर यू हैव दिस फेनोमेनॉन सीन ड्यूरिंग फ्लैश फोटोग्राफी. दैट्स व्हाट द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस पर्टिकुलर इमेज. लेट अस मूव फॉरवर्ड टुवर्ड्स अनदर स्ट्रक्चर कॉल्ड एज आयरिस. Basically, they are covering the lens as well as important in controlling the diameter of the lens. For example, if there's something in front of me and I'm looking at it very much closer, my lens will be smaller in size so as to limit the amount of light entering my eyes. If there's something beyond this height, if there's something beyond this particular distance, if something is very much far away from my eyes, my eyelids will be actually becoming bigger in size. You must have seen that even in the mirror too. Just come in front of the mirror and look at yourself. Your eyes will be actually smaller if you go closer to you, and if you move beyond by distance, your eyes will be getting bigger. Or just do one thing, take something in front of your parents' eye. मम्मी के या फिर पापा के आंखों के सामने कुछ तो लेके जाओ. आपको ये समझेगा कि मम्मी या फिर पापा के आंखें ऐसे छोटी हो जाती है. तो उनकी आंखों को छोटी करने का काम किसने किया? Iris. Iris are the basic muscles there who are working for the same. In this way, iris doesn't allow the light to pass inside, because of which your eyes will not be damaged because of those iris muscles. Okay, so these are your iris muscles. You can see here they have a particular color, violet color, we all know it's because of melanin. So in this way we have this color of the eyes due to melanin. So as a summary for today's session, what we talked here was regarding our eyes. We talked when the eyes were developed first. We talked about nolitus, the organism which had the eyes, pit eyes, or jiske andar ek hole tha, lekin un eyes ke paas lens nahi tha. We talked about the compound eyes within a mosquito, within a house fly too. We talked about a disease called as nocturnal legophthalmos, a disease due to your neuron damage, jiske wajah se aapki aankhein completely band nahi ho sakti. We talked about various structures like eyelids. We talked why your eyelids are basically, who is controlling those eyelids. We talked about sclera. It's white in color, it has blood vessels. We also did say that sclera, how it is actually important for maintaining the blood vessel as well as the oxygen transportation to your lens, because your lens doesn't have blood vessels, so which means lens will not get oxygen if you're asleep. Similarly, we also talked about ciliary muscles, and we are completed with this complete colored structure, not the middle hole, but this complete colored structure. In this way, we have completed many such structures regarding our eyes. Thank you for attending this session. Do like and subscribe.